Hello guys, Ruby Naka here. Yesterday, I received one of the most difficult messages from a good friend of mine, which said to the effect that there are children with special needs lost their parents to COVID. What options are out there? You know, to me, to think about even healthy and normal children losing their parents for any circumstances is painful, and to even to think about children with special needs, it got to be devastating. My friend didn't tell me about what kind of special needs, but the kind of work that he does gave me an indication that he may be referring to children with intellectual disabilities like autism. So I started thinking about it yesterday, and I have few thoughts. I thought to put it into video to share with you all. If that could be of any help to you, please make use of it. First thing that I want to tell you is about the preference of choices for a child in need of care and protection that JJ Act offers. These children that my friend is referring to are the children in need of care and protection. So for such kind of children, what options does JJ Act provide? First option is always biological parents, in which this case they've lost their biological parents. So the second choice is adoptive parents. Third choice is foster care. Fourth choice is sponsorship. And then comes is the institutional care. Now, as I told you, biological parents are no more because of COVID. So the second one is adoptive families. You know, adoption process has become so stringent in India. It takes time for these children to be brought into the system and match with the prospective adoptive parents. So the next option is foster care. Foster care has three different kinds: non-formal kinship care, family foster care, and group foster care. So kinship care means either the extended family or joint family members of the parents can take care of these children. If such families are not there or unwilling to take care of them, other members of the community, like friends of the parents, community, or the tribe, which shares the similar kind of cultural values of the child, could also take care of them. That is what is called as kinship care. And then the other options, family foster care, group foster care, all this will take time. So I'm only going to talk about the kinship care. Kinship care is very clearly stated as a definition in the model guidelines of foster care of Ministry of Women and Child Development in guideline 2, sub-guideline A18, is where this definition is stated. Kinship care means a child's extended or joint family taking care of them. Now, in the model foster care guidelines 3, it says about what is available for the kinship care families. There are no formal guidelines as such in the guidelines, how to do it and what is the procedure to take care of it. Is basically, this is your brother's son or a sister's daughter, you just take them into your family and you take care of them. So the government said there are no guidelines because it is very much embedded into our cultural ethos. But they did something very smart. They extended financial support to such kind of families if they so desire. So if any kinship families out there willing to look after these COVID orphans, with special needs. I just want you to know that there is financial assistance available to the tune of 4,000 rupees per child per month. If you are interested, you need to approach your district's child welfare committee or district child protection unit. If you do not know where to find them, you simply dial child emergency phone line 1098. They will surely know the phone numbers and the physical locations of these institutions, and they should be able to guide you to meet these people to present your need. And from there on, they are responsible to take care of extending such a kind of a financial assistance to you. I hope this video is of some help to you. If it did, please give me a like, share it, comment on it, and most importantly, do not forget to send me your questions. Till we meet again, goodbye.